Hello everyone. Today I have delivered lecture on fluvial process landforms. Fluvial process means those landforms are produced due to the weathering, erosion and deposition of the river erosion or river deposition called as fluvial process landform. This study is also called as fluvial geomorphology. Fluvial geomorphology means the branch of geomorphology which deals with the study of landform produced from erosion, weathering and deposition through the river action or stream action, river or stream action called as fluvial geomorphology. And in these landforms, there are two types of landforms are found in this type, erosional and depositional landform. Number one, what is the process of fluvial process of landform? Fluvial means the erosion, weathering and depositional due to the river flowing. The river water, running water are responsible for weathering of bedrock of the river channel called as erosional landforms of river channel or erosional landforms of fluvial process. Another one is depositional landform. Depositional landform means those landforms are deposited due to the weathering and weathered and erosion material transported from one place to another place, both the bank of river channel and near to the deltic system when the river or stream join the ocean and then form this structure is called as delta. Delta is one of the example of depositional landform of fluvial processes. Okay, the erosional work of stream river cut shape of landscape throughout their flow. Function of the river is as follows: erosion, transportation and deposition. What is the function of river? There are three functions of the river, that is the erosion, transportation and deposition. Erosion means the rock has been broken into the smaller pieces of the rock called as erosion. Transported means this erosional material are transported from one place to another place through the river channel or through the flood of the river called as transportation. And this transported material deposited either both the bank of river, whether it is left bank or whether it is the right bank of the river channel, or when the river entered into the ocean, then from delta the river cannot directly join the ocean. They form subtributaries, distributaries of the high flood level water entered into the ocean called as delta. Bird foot like structures, you know, bird foots like structures are called as delta. These are the three functions of the river: erosion, transportation and deposition. What is meant by erosion? Erosion means the rock get a smaller pieces in the form of small sediments called as erosion. River channel has been eroded, bedrock of the river has been eroded due to the velocity of water during the heavy rainfall season or snow melt. The river flowing is high intensity level, and when heavy rainfall or heavy snowfall, then melting of this snow melt, the river level is rises, the flood level is rises, and due to the velocity of water, the rock bedrock of the earth, bedrock of the river channel has been eroded or broken into the smaller pieces called as erosion. Erosion into four ways. Erosion will be taken place into four ways. Number one, abrasion and corrosion. Load carried by river will crush against its bed. Load carried by river will crush against its bed. Bed means bedrock of the river channel. Okay. Erosion. Attrition. Attrition is another important factor of the erosion. When bed of the river broken into the smaller pieces, bed of the river, suppose you are going to field geological fieldwork of the river channel, the bedrock of the river, some of the rock has been broken due to the high velocity of water called as attrition. Another is hydraulic action. What is meant by hydraulic action? Hydraulic action means the work of turbulence in the water. The running water causes resistance in the joints of the rock in stream channels. Joints of the rocks has been broken. Jointed rock. Suppose in the bank of the bedrock of the river channel has been jointed rocks. These jointeds are broken into the smaller pieces called as hydraulic action. Joint may be enlarged. Loose fragments of rocks get removed away from the bed. Bed means bottom of the river channel called as river bed. This river bed has been broken due to the velocity of water, and this rock has been converted into the smaller pieces of the sediment called as hydraulic action of erosion. Then solution and corrosion. Corrosion means the few minerals in the rock like limestones can be dissolved in water. Some of the minerals and some of the rocks will be dissolved into the water because of their characteristics. This action is called as solution, means also one of the example of erosion. Attrition, corrosion, solution, hydraulic action and abrasion. These are the four ways of the erosion of river channel. Then after erosion, this erosional material has been transported from one place to another place. First thing is erosion. These erosion materials are transported from one place to another place, from mountainous to the joining the next higher order or next stream. Suppose small streams are joined in a major stream. This is the process of river flowing. Between this flowing stream, there are different regions to transport sediment, erosional sediment, move away from the mountainous to the low-lying areas called as transportation. Suppose this is the river flow, here is weathering and erosion. These erosional and sedimentary material passing through the river channel through the velocity of water from one place to another place called as transportation. Okay. In transportation also have four ways. Number one, traction. What is meant by traction? Traction is larger and heavier rock or gravels are rotated along the bed. Suppose some of the larger and heavier rock gravels means those are larger size of the sediment called as gravel. In the sediment, there are different types of sediment. Boulder means those rock sediments are more than 256 mm called as boulder. Lesser than boulder, that is the pebble. The pebble size is 56 to 260, 64 to 256 mm called as pebble. Then cobble size is 4 mm to 4 mm size of the sediment. Then lesser size than the cobble called as gravel. Gravel means 4 mm, greater than 4 mm size of the sediment, and less than lesser size than the gravel, that is the sand. Then silt, then clay. These are the sediment, different types of sediment based on the size of the particle. Suppose smallest particle is fine clay, greater than clay, that is the silt, greater than silt, that is the sediment. Sediment again divided to different sediments, fine sediment, medium sediment, coarse sediment. 2 mm size of the sediment is called sediment. Then gravel, then pebble, then cobble, and then boulder. When larger and heavier rocks are like gravel means more than 4 mm size of the sediments are rotated along the river bed called as traction. Then saltation. Saltation means smaller and lighter rock fragments like silt and clay and sand bounce along the river channel called as saltation. Then suspension, some of the load like silt and clay, very fine grained sediments will float along the river water. Suppose you go to the river flowing water, some of the clay and sand silt particles are floating on water due to the lighter particle of the sediment. They may be only deposited when stream velocity reaches near zero. When the velocity of water is near to zero, and then this silt and clay particle are deposited bed of the river channel. This process is called as suspension. Then fourth way is solution. Solution means some minerals are transported in dissolved forms. Some minerals are transported in dissolved forms, especially chemical solution derived from minerals like soil, limestone and dolomite. Limestone and dolomite have calcium carbonate, and calcium carbonate, nature of calcium carbonate, it will be dissolved in water. This is called as solution. Then another deposition. This one, first one erosion, then deposition and transportation, and third one deposition. Deposition means a river will drop its load when volume decreases and speed decreases. When flood water volume, suppose this is the river channel, it is full level of the flood level. Above the flood level, and when volume decreases, the sediment and silt and clay will be the deposited within the at the bottom of the river bed or at the bottom of the river channel. When speed decreases and volume decreases, without decreasing of volume and speed cannot possible, this floated material like silt and clay cannot be deposited at the bed of river channel. When they deposited, when volume of water will be decreased and speed of water will be decreased, and these floated material on the water channel will be the deposited at the bottom of river channel. Another is a river volume decreases when river water decreases in dry season. Suppose in rainy season the flood level is very high. When goes into the dry season, means winter and summer, the volume of river will be the decreases. Then dry region with high evaporation. When the high evaporation rate but greater than precipitation evaporation is more, that time this depositation will happen. Then presence of permeable rock, also another important of the presence of permeable rock, because of permeable means the ability of fluid from transfer to one place to another place called as permeability. Permeability is depends upon the porosity of rock. When the high porous rock, it will be the useful for the deposition of these floating sediments, then receding the flood waters. These are the processes of deposition. River speed decreases. When river speed decreases, enters a lake. When river enters into the lake or ocean, the speed of river will be automatically decreases because of the volume is high, intensity is also high, but area will be the larger. So you know, at the time of origin of river channel will be the very thin thickness of the river, but when goes up to the low next stages, the river will be the broad, the river river thickness is will be the broad. When enters a sea or enters a ocean, the river speed will be the decreases. Enters a gently sloping plain, also the speed of river will be the decrease. The work of the river depends on the energy of function, the volume of water and speed of water flow. The volume of water and speed of water is responsible for the any type of functioning of the river channel. Okay, then we see one by one fluvial landforms. Which fluvial landforms are produced due to the fluvial process? Fluvial process means that which geomorphological landforms are produced or resulting due to the fluvial erosion. Fluvial erosion means river erosion. Geomorphology, the study of surface features of the earth. Geomorphology definition, the study of surface of earth curved by the river, wind or glacial action or marine action called as geomorphology. There are four main types of geomorphology. Fluvial geomorphology means those landforms are produced due to the river channel or river flow called as fluvial geomorphology. Those landforms are produced due to the erosion and depositional process through the coastal process called as coastal geomorphology. And those landforms, erosional and depositional landform, produced due to the wind action, means wind action, called as Aeolian geomorphology. And another is glacial geomorphology. Glacial means in the mountainous terrains, in the glacial landforms, some of the erosional and depositional landform produced called as glacial landform. Okay, today we have learned about the fluvial geomorphology. River means, what is meant by river? River is a channel of water from high altitude to low altitude through the catchment area of the particular region. The water comes from the catchment area into the some linear structures called as river. Running water is the most important agent of erosion on the continents. One of the most important erosional factor of that is the river on the continent. And the stream valley are the most common landform. Stream valley, most of the Himalayan rivers are forms a valley, V-shaped valley, U-shaped valley. It is a product of erosional landforms of river channel. River flowing to the ocean drain about 68% of the earth land surface. The remainder of the land either is covered by ice or drains to the closed basins. Means near about river flowing to the ocean drain about 62% of the earth's land surface. The remainder, that land either is covered by the ice or drained to the closed basin. River gradually mould the land by eroding away the material in some places and depositing it in other places. Okay. River system consisting of main channel. River places consisting of a main channel, that is the trunk stream. A river system can be divided into the three different systems: collecting system, transporting system, and dispersing system. Collecting system means branches consisting of network tributaries in the headward region collect and funnel water sediment to the main stream. Collecting stream means like this. Suppose this is the area, this is she, you know, this is one stream. Okay, you seen this picture? Okay, I will use another dark color. This one, okay, you see this? This is the major river and these are the tributaries. You see this or no? This like structure, okay, seen this type of structure, that is the river channel. Okay, see this type, this is the first order river and this is the first order. When two river join, called as second order river. Okay, this one. Then transporting system, the main trunk system function a channel through which water and sediments from collecting area towards the ocean, called as transporting system. And third one is dispersing system, consisting of network distributaries to the mouth of river delta. When delta means the when streams are formed different distributaries. This is the one stream, then form some distributaries called as delta. This type of structure, this one. Seen? Seen or not? This type of structure. This is the delta and this is the tributaries. This is the distributary. That is the difference between distributary and tributary. Distributary, this is the distributary. One river produces different channel called as distributary. This happens where the river entered into the ocean, then form this type of structure like delta. And this is the drainage basin, drainage channel. Join one stream to another stream, then form second stream. This is the drainage basin. This is the delta. This like structure. Okay. Parts of the river: tributary, distributary, upstream, downstream, delta, meander and braided channel. These are the different parts of the river. Tributary means this is the river, see, and then form this is a tributary. Distributary, this is the distributary. First below figure form this. You see, this is the distributary, this is the tributary. Upstream means upper part of the river. Suppose this is the river channel, this is the river channel, this is the upper part of the upstream part of the river channel, and downstream means lower part of the stream, that is the downstream. And meander means snake-like structures are developed, called as meandering. And braided channel, river divided into the multiple channels, called as braided river channel. Okay. Drainage pattern, there are different drainage pattern. Okay, dendritic drainage pattern, parallel drainage pattern, linear drainage pattern, radial drainage pattern, rectangular drainage pattern, trellis drainage pattern, annual drainage pattern, centripetal drainage pattern and centrifugal drainage pattern. These are the different drainage pattern. Dendritic drainage pattern means irregular branches pattern like a many direction, like a many direction, called as dendritic drainage pattern. See, this type of structures then directly join the subtributaries. Dendritic drainage pattern and parallel drainage pattern means every smaller drainage are flowing parallel to the drainage pattern. I will send you notes in PPT format. You will see all the drainage structures in the PPT, like drainage pattern and also some of the geomorphological landforms also. Okay, parallel drainage pattern, dendritic drainage pattern. The first thing, I will discuss only theoretical concept. All the figures you will see in the PowerPoint presentation. I will send you on your Google Classroom or WhatsApp group. Dendritic drainage pattern. Dendritic drainage pattern means irregular branching pattern. Trees like. Dendritic drainage pattern. It common in massive rocks. Where form the dendritic drainage pattern? Dendritic drainage pattern are mostly found in the massive type of igneous rocks or crystalline rocks. Due to the strong resistance of rock, headward development of valley is negligible. Where the very less resistance or very less weathering happening, there the dendritic drainage pattern will be the form. Parallel drainage pattern. Parallel drainage pattern means this type of drainage pattern. All streams are flowing parallel like this. Okay. Parallel drainage pattern. And when form parallel drainage pattern, common in terrain homogeneous rocks. Homogeneous means only one rocks presence on the surface of the earth, then form parallel drainage pattern. Then radial drainage pattern. Radial drainage pattern means streams radiates out from the center of the topographic higher. Center of the topographic higher. This one. Suppose all streams are just start from like this. I will draw first and then show you. These type of structures. Most rivers are originating from one place. These types of drainage system. This is the radial drainage pattern. All the rivers are start from here and goes here. Okay. Here. This is the origin point of the river channel. Why this form the drainage pattern? Stream radiates out from the center of the topographic higher because common in volcanic terrain. These type of drainage patterns are most commonly in the volcanic terrain. Another is rectangular drainage pattern. Rectangular means channels marked by right angle beds. All the beds are right angle. This type. This type of drainage pattern found, that is the right angle. All the drainage from start from right angle, called as rectangular drainage pattern. The rectangular drainage pattern are commonly due to the presence of joints and fracture. Where the presence of fractures and joints and in the massive rocks or foliation in metamorphic rock. These types of drainage patterns are mostly found in the massive type of rocks, mostly in the jointed and fracture type of igneous rocks and metamorphic rocks. Then trellis drainage pattern. It is the same rectangular arrangement of channel which principal tributary streams are parallel in very long, like fens train on the trellis. The pattern is common in the areas where outcropping edges of folded sedimentary rock. And another is annular drainage pattern. Annular means stream follow nearly circular like this. like this one, this one, this. Okay. Centrifugal force, centripetal drainage pattern means centrifugal force. When all the drainage comes within the one area. Suppose this is the one lake, all the streams join these lakes, like vice versa of like first leg. This one, okay, this type of structure, you know, you see this diagram, okay. All the river joins the one particular lakes from all other sides, called as centripetal drainage pattern. Streams converge towards the central depression, such as volcanic crater. Suppose one of the example of Lonare, all the streams join the these lakes from centripetal force like structures, centrifugal. Okay, that is the centripetal drainage pattern. This is the how what is stream order. Suppose this is the basin, okay, you see this diagram, this is the below diagram, see, okay, this is the main stream, this is the smaller stream, okay, this is the first order stream. Then when first order joins, then called as second order, this is second order. Then when two second order joins, this one and this one, then this is the third order stream. This is the stream ordering. It is computed by the Strahler method. Okay, Strahler method, you should see this diagram. First order, when two first order, then start second order, then again first order, then this is second order, then two second order join, then form third order stream. This is the how to ordering of stream. These types of method developed by Strahler in 1954, that is the method of ordering of stream. Then fluvial landforms, braided river channel exhibit the numerous channels that split off and regions each other, give braided appearance. Braided river channels, they typically carry coarse grain sediment down steep gradient. Coarse grain means pebble, cobble and boulders down towards the low lying areas, called as braided river channel. You should see details figure in my PowerPoint presentation, which will send on your WhatsApp group or on Google Classroom. Meandering, what is mean by meandering? I already discussed about the meandering. This like snake like structures develop in the river channel, called as meandering. Braided river meandering is contrast to braided river channel. Contrast to the braided river channel, this type of structures, this is meandering, snake like structures. It is very contrast to the braided river. Meandering river typically contains one channel that winds its way across the floodplain. As it is flow, it deposits sediments on the bank, both the bank of right and left bank, sediment deposits. Like sediment deposit both the bank of river channel, that is the meandering. And when form oxbowlic, when these meandering cut by other structure, then form oxbowlic. Ox means ox animal, the ox bow, you know, bow, oxes of bow. There are two bows on head of ox, is called as bow. The oxbow like structures are formed here, meandering. Okay, when meandering cut, then form oxbow like structures. You know, also delta means the river create some tributaries when enters into the ocean. Here this is the delta. Okay, birth foot like structure, birth hen foot means cocks. Hen foots like structures are formed due to the deposition of sediment when before the entering of the ocean of the ocean of river. Before enter into the ocean, some structures are developed, that is the delta, like bird foot like structures called as delta. This is the depositional landform. This is the depositional landform. Then meandering both the bank of meandering. This is the meandering both the bank of river channel. Natural levee means wall like structures are developed both the bank of river called as natural levee. Okay, this is also depositional landform. Meandering is erosional landform. Okay, when I already told about some bedrock at the bottom of the river channel, some gullies and circles are developed due to the various due to the action of eddies of the river. Some pebbles and cobbles are eroded bedrock of the river called as potholes. These types of structure called as potholes. The gravels are motion due to the velocity of water. These gravels are rounded shaped structures are formed into the at the bottom of the river channel called as potholes. The potholes depth is more than 1 meter 2 meter. And suppose I in last 2 years back we will visited the Gokak at Ghataprabha river channel. So many potholes are present at the bottom of the bedrock of the at the bottom of river channel called as potholes. Then this is the natural levee. This is the depositional landform. Meandering is erosional landform. Oxbow leak is also erosional landform. Delta is depositional landform. Natural levee both the bank of river channel called as depositional landform. Another is waterfall. Suppose this is the river channel. Then when flood water, then form waterfall. Waterfall is an example of erosional landform. Detailed diagrams you will see in your PPT, in your WhatsApp group or in your Google Classroom. I will send all the figures for your reference. Okay. Any doubts on this fluvial geomorphology, you will write email or write chatting on WhatsApp or Google Classroom regarding any landform, erosional and depositional, and any other doubt on this topic, please write email or on WhatsApp. Okay.